I'd like to introduce with full band in gridlock social isolation, the one, the only, Kate Ceberano.
Thank you so very much for that awesome opener. Thank you. And good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is a great pleasure to be here. I am with my band, and I got to be honest with you, I could cry. It's so bloody awesome. All right. Here we go. Just let's get back to something familiar, shall we? A song I wrote a real long time ago. It's never been more apt than probably in these times. Wouldn't you agree? I could hear the calling a million miles away as my heartbeat fills the silence with words I can't say. My mother used to tell me, she said, girl, your time will come. And so I sit there, I hold. My time has just begun, and I will never walk away. Just be brave and stay. Hold me to the end, and in your arms arise up high. I look for tomorrow. I remember yesterday. Oh, when I was scared of the darkness, saying things that I shouldn't say. But now my life has changed. Just look what I've become. I won't sit back, I won't hold tight. Begun. And I will never walk away. Just be brave and stay. Hold me to the end. And in your arms arise up high. Life has been fine as a child until now. And I've missed a feeling of an audience, and it is indeed something that we live for as musicians and as artists. We've just travelled such a long road learning how to be performers. To be put at home to seemingly no good, no use. I'm just going to turn into a fat alcoholic. I can feel it. Or maybe not. We'll just, you know. Maybe I'll have to sublimate. You feel me? Speaking of sublimation, this song was written by a dear friend of mine. His name's Paul Gray. He's no longer with us today, but you may remember him from Wawanee, and I want you to remember him as one of the sexiest little white guys who sang like Prince. and he had the heart of an ox. I love this man. Yeah. Woo! Our love will be the first across this universe. No space, no distance, no time. Our love has just begun. Two planets have aligned to share the light of the sun. Oh, I spend my days wishing upon a star. Like as I travel, hoping to find where you are. And baby, I've conquered planets just to be here with you. Nothing on earth makes me feel like you do. Oh, 'cause you've become the moon by my heart. Stars and satellites won't keep us apart. Every now and then when you call my name, stars and satellites light up the sky again. Fear inside this atmosphere, so feel free to be who you are. There is no way of coming down, no darling, not when that light is around. And love is blessed by the sun. Oh, I spend my days wishing upon a star. Light years I've traveled. Just to be here with you. Nothing on earth makes me feel like you do. Ain't that right, Jessica Fairley? Yeah. 'Cause you've become the moon by my heart. Stars and satellites won't keep us apart. And every now and then when you call my name, stars and satellites light up the sky. Roddy Bustos on the bass, would you do it again? Please, would you? One more time. Do it again. To some significant business here, and it's got to be said, I have been around for a very long time. And does that diminish me by becoming one of the elders of Australian rock and roll and jazz and soul? No, in fact, makes me feel that I've lived enough decades to be an expert in how to make love songs make you cry. This song, I Don't Know How to Love Him, was one of the first songs I ever wanted to perform. I watched a movie called Jesus Christ Superstar And there was this Hawaiian actress, Yvonne Elliman, and I said, you know what? I've got the right moves, I'm the right colour, I come from Northbourne, I'm going to be Mary Magdalene. You think that's strange, and yet fact is always stranger than fiction. And there we cut to Jesus Christ Superstar. This was a song, I was booked to sing it for 9 shows, and it went for 100 and something shows, so enjoy. To do how to move him, I've been changed, yes, really changed in these past few days. When I've seen myself, I seem like someone else. I don't know how to take this. I don't see why he moves. Just a man, and I've had so many men before in very many ways. He's just one more. Should I bring him down? Should I scream and shout? Should I speak of love? Let my feelings out. I never thought. Think it's rather funny that I should be in this position. I'm the one who's always been so calm, so cool. No love is fool on in every show. He scares me so. Should I bring him down? Should I scream and shout? Should I speak of love? Let my feelings out. I never thought I'd come to this. Oh, what's it all about? 'Cause yeah, if he said he loved, Friday. I couldn't cope. No, I just couldn't cope. I turned my head, I'd back away. I wouldn't to know. He scares me so. Oh, I love thank you. Let's talk about our love. Can't live without only each other. Silence in the room. What's going on with you? lover, why won't you let me in? Why won't you let me in? Talk about our love before it turns to dust. Oh yes, there is a warmth so high I can't get inside your hand.
Oh, thank you on the set. You're very kind. I mean, you know what, you guys, you've got to be enthusiastic because, of course, you're creating the energy of what would ordinarily be, what, 18,000 people. Yeah, just like that. You've just done it. Just the eight of you, each 1,000 each. Yeah, I felt that. And you're doing an awfully good job, and I'm so glad you're here. Can I just say from my heart and to all of you guys here today and tonight, we are so grateful for the gig and your support of live music and what you're doing to contribute and create a way to communicate and connect with people is freaking awesome. And we on the stage would love to give you a big round of applause. Thank you very, very much. Thank you for having us. Now, we were discussing what the introversion is like at home, and it gets quite deep at times because there's a lot of time to think and perhaps too much time to think. But I would like to just take you into a space where we were devoid of problems like that, maybe in around 1978. I'm going to take you to New York, to the Bowery, and I'm going to go and bring in a little bit of my mates who inspired me as a kid, one of whom was Blondie. We're not going to perform a Blondie song, but I'm going to perform a string of songs that were celebrating what I thought was that wonderful punk princess that I had within me at Westfield Shopping Centre. Living in 9 Lime Avenue, North Bourne. with my back against a wall, experiencing being pashed for the first time.
Sharp and sit and wait a while and fake a smile so no one can tell it's raining inside of my head. I sit and smile at all the passers-by, but on the sly I'm quietly wishing that they were all dead. Smoking's no good for my health. I know that by the time I'm far from here, my head will clear and I could feel as worthy as any.
Come in, baby, but you know I'll say.
solicit urge. There's a part of me just got to splurge. I really like to just hang around. Come back into bed, babe. Turn off your phone. Pass in the kiss.
Like the guy from Screaming Jets then. You won't be needing the minute more. I know you'll feel like I... Hi, Dave Gleason, if you're watching. Love you. I know it's vain by definition. But when I'm in, I just imagine. Honey, right now, I don't care. And if I change, I'll give you a warning. Until the time they just be a darling. Scattered clothes and a telephone number tattooed to your palm. In the morning you wake up too alone, feeling guilty. Another 8 more bars to go. Love is alive, is alive. Well, again, I'm having such an unexpected, joyful experience being in a space which, well, generally speaking, in 30 or 40 years of performing, might feel somewhat sterile, but considering the circumstances and because I'm so grateful, I'm having the time of my life. The time of my life. And I never felt this way before. Sorry, just while the last, you know, just to prove that we are coming at you alive. And yes, it is a pleasure, a great pleasure to be here with my band. Please, at home, big round of applause for this incredible ensemble of musicians. It's Jack and Jess and Dave. and Roddy and Kathleen Halloran, whom I lovingly called and bequeathed her with her first nickname, and that is Keith. So should you see her in the street, she would be hereafter known as Keith, as in Keith Richards, because she's cool. And anywho, can you believe it that it's now over 30 years old, this song? And I'd like to think that we were trailblazers in the 80s, and I feel like in many ways we were, because we weren't asking permission, and God help me, perhaps we should have. But this is one song I truly adore, still hate the title, but think it's a great reggae song. So let's give it a red hot crack.
Resist you, no matter how I try. After all this time, can't believe that I'm about to take this ride. Said it was over, decided we are strong. I convinced myself that somebody else could take the place of you. With those eyes, those bedroom eyes, I made a promise to myself that I would invisible my mind, leave the past behind, be done with you for good. Oh, but then I saw ya, knew that I had lied. I found out just how much I crave your touch to keep me satisfied. Be myself as long as I can see myself reflected in your eyes. Bedroom eyes, bedroom eyes, I'm lost for words, so hypnotized. I can feel it in my heart, it's about to start. With those eyes, those bedroom eyes, bedroom eyes, bedroom eyes, I must admit.
Now, as far as I can tell, we are getting to the pointy end of what is the end of the set. And again, I'd like to say thank you very much for having us here. Now, not sure how the rules go here for doing encores and just dead set malarkey, and we can just hang out, we can do that. The boss says we can. Well, all right then. Well, I'd like to sort of leave you with, from someone who is... been in the business for such a long time as I, and feel that I'm probably one of the few of the older women, should I say the elders, and actually just had a chat today with Renee Geyer, and the two of us have been deciding that perhaps we ought to do something together, which would be amazing. Well, what I wanted to say is I'd like to leave it here with my love and obsession with Australian music, and it's the live system of performing here in this country that's made my career as long and as lasting as it's been. So I'm going to leave you with a song by my idol and someone who I sat in the wings and watched avidly for every menacing, prowling, predatory glance, the great Chrissy Amphlett.
Yes, indeed. Australian titan, K Kate Ceberano. How about that? I know it's a weird concept, but as you know, Kate is used to, this is a little bit of a jazz concept. I know the idea of buying a ticket to a show that you've already seen is kind of weird, but think of it as being a piano man with a fishbowl on the grand piano, passing the hat around, you know, head to Delivered Live and buy a ticket, because if anything, that is a display of intricate professionalism and entertainment, the likes of which I'm not sure I can handle. That was absolutely incredible. And I'm so excited that she's here right now to have a little chat. I can't believe it. Kate Ceberano, yes, indeed, with... a gothic fan.
I figured at this age you must travel with your own fan. Do I need this as well?
Yeah,
I do.
Pop that on.
Shall I sit up here? Oh, look at that.
Why not? Oh, we've got...
Can I just say, I'm really enjoying your cabaret jacket. And it's the snow leopard, is it not?
Yeah, it is. I thought because it's sort of heading into winter, I need it for protection. It's been pretty chilly here at the moment. So
you
this
need
is
no
a
excuse to look so cool, I'm just saying.
That means really, a lot coming from you.
Well, you know, I'm just saying.
You nailed it. You've been around, to quote you, 34...
I feel so
34.
Far away from you, by the way. Is this for branding reasons down here? Good. Well, we'll keep that.
This is exactly what I'm asking about. I'm wondering, you know, as an industry professional of decades, did you ever think you'd see anything like this? How weird is this?
You know, one of the things that most professionals do is they try to see things before they happen. And I mean, you know, like for instance, this evening I was imagining how our conversation might go. And I actually, in my imagination, I burst into tears because I wanted to tell something which is true. And that is that when it landed and we were at home and all the gigs were falling off the calendar and a year ahead, I thought, this is it. This is my retirement. This is the end. Because how could you hope to continue to do something against all odds whilst everyone else hasn't yet had a go, you know? And I didn't sing for quite some time, not for a few weeks while we were in ISO. And the only thing I could do, which was really rogue, was to get a step from Kmart and do step dance with my girlfriend.
Someone mentioned it online. streaming a sort of dance.
No, I'll tell you what happened was... See, I'm quite committed to promoting the arts, and I have done for so many years. But the arts don't just encapsulate rock and roll. They have Broadway dancing and singing, and there's cabaret artists.
There's cabaret and jazz,
as we said. No, truly, and all of that. And I've been the artistic director, you know, should I say the artistic director,
Ooh-la-la.
As opposed to the artistic director. Of the Cabaret Festival, which is the biggest in the world, by the way, Adelaide's Cabaret Festival.
Is it?
300 acts we employed.
What do you think it is about Adelaide that makes them so passionate about cabaret?
I think they're passionate about the arts, and I think they do it so well. The audience are really well-versed in how to receive art and music, and they've been getting the best of international artists coming there for their arts festival for 25-plus years, 30 years. And so they understand that sometimes to go through... a Chekhov play in Russian for 5.5 hours is something one endures and one accepts.
That is, I've never heard anything quite as free jazz as that.
Indeed. It's Miles on crack, and which he was all... Sorry, we won't go there. But anyway...
No, it's late night on the internet. No one cares.
No one cares.
Everyone knows French, like I say.
Yeah, right. Well, actually, did I tell you on the way here that Siri made a French... She said, we're going to take a left. She says, take a left at Saint-Georges Road. Saint-Georges Road. That was the most hilarious thing I've ever heard. It's worth going to Turek just to check and see how that sounds with Siri. But I think what I wanted to... I'm actually making light of something that was quite grave. You know, we said the step dance thing, right? Mm. My girlfriend, Chiara, is one of the greatest dancers I think I've ever seen. You know, not since something like... you know, when you saw as a kid those old vintage films on the midday movies and Sid Charisse would come on, or, you know, Rita Hayworth, and there's legs up to Ye Young and seemingly effortless
dancing, and she'd just gone for some audition. I believe it was for Moulin Rouge, which has now been cancelled and won't be probably deferred till 21, you know. I don't think people understand how long it takes to be that great and to have your hopes dashed like that. It was all I could do was to put my vanity on a bonfire and say, let's get the fuck up on a step and move and make a parody of something brilliant, which is this is the professional version and this is clearly the amateur version.
What?
And actually, we've got this profound sort of love from people because, of course, that's what we're all doing, aren't we, and ISO?
I actually like, from what I can... You've been actually kind of a frontiers person. You've been a, like, cowboy, cowgirl. You've been quite prolific on the streaming front. You know, has it been scary? What's it been like being on the frontier? You did a streaming gig from Mimo and you've been broadcasting from your house and now you're here. What's it like, you know, facing the bleak entertainment industry head on, facing this virus head on? Are you scared?
Yeah, I mean, it was like World War III, really, wasn't it? And then you bring into the mix that I have a teenage daughter who, how do you explain that her 16th year is going to be the shittest one of in her memory, you know?
16 is shit for a lot of people out there. I'm not saying
with or without COVID.
Yeah, but, totally. But this is an extra.
It was rough, you know, and I just felt that. As I've always been led, I don't want to go anywhere if I can't bring everyone with me. And the streaming thing was an opportunity that I thought I could help my friends, my band primarily, get a bit of lolly money because not every one of them are all eligible for all of the employment benefits. I don't even think I am, but I, you know, I've just got to look after you. Just don't sort of drop your babies on the side of the road and say, oh, okay, that's it, fend for yourself. I mean, these are people I've worked with for 25 years and 35 years, and sound engineers and road crew. And so I thought, okay, fuck it, I'm going to do this again. I'm going to learn something that's heroically stupid to try to learn at the age of 50-something.
Whatever.
But, and you know, keep pulling back the phone's out of the young millennials' hands who've been helping me. They're wonderful. But do you find that young people pull the phones and stuff like let me do that.
Don't touch don't
it. Let me do it. That. Give me the... And I said, no, you know what? Just give me the fucking thing. I'm going to learn.
I'm going to put down my fan and I'm going to pick up the
smartphone. I'm going to have my menopause fever. It gives me fever. Huh. Hey, oh, my God. And it hits at this time of night, which really sucks. However, I did learn, and I believe we've been a bit, what is that word? I know, well, anyway, I think that we've been trailblazers on it because the sound has been very good and we've managed to do it and have a few secrets as well, which make it look a little bit showy.
I like it. Bit of magic behind the scenes.
Bit of magic.
So do you feel we had a lot of, you mentioned your band and how exciting it was to have a six-piece band on stage. You know, everyone has their own 1.5-metre box that they have to stay in to maintain social distance. Was it sort of exciting to have all those guys? Can you tell us a little bit about them? Because everyone loved, love for everyone on stage.
First of all, people should understand that I have one of the greatest assets of my home life, and that is that Keith lives out the back. And
so in a granny flat.
She has an apartment in the yard. So when COVID hit, it was like, okay, that's it. I'm going to be the piano player. You're going to be the guitarist. She has to endure my sort of, you know, the three-finger chords across all of the... Anyway, she's a genius, that kid.
She...
Kathleen Halloran
totally slayed.
Slays. And then you should check out her on Insta. She does these...
What is she on Insta? What's her handle?
Kathleen Halloran.
Kathleen Halloran.
Halloran. And she... Halloran. I think it's an underscore somewhere in there. But she does like duets, or should I say duels, with, you know, guitarists from Baby Animals and... I mean, she's fierce. And she just, like, she's the shredder.
The tone. Exceptional. The
I know. She's really stunning. Rod Bustos, the bass player, and I... We just made a record with Steve Kilby and Sean Sennett just before we went into this meltdown of the world.
And it's a little bit... I'm a bit twangy myself when I play. I love the fact that it draws on that sort of little bit twangy classic songwriting thing with Steve. You know, I'm loving it. What took you in that direction, you two? Because you're two legends of the industry.
Well, again, as you noticed, I love Australian rock. Mm. And I was raised on a diet and as a teenager sitting in the wings and opening up for most of the Australian greats like the Divinals and Cold Chisel and Mossy and Renee and the whole clan, really, I was there.
The Divinals team brought the house down, by the way. Lots of heart emojis in particular.
Oh, my God.
A couple of butterflies and a fair degree of roses for Chrissy as well.
Oh, yeah. Well, she deserves it because her legacy was that she left that for women to touch themselves and get their boobs checked regularly. That was the heroic kind of overtone of that. We miss her. Renee and I, we literally spoke today and how that felt to be sort of like the last of the Mohicans, really, we really are. Mm. But Roddy and I, so he and I produced that record. We did it all, it was almost prescient because we did it virtually and I'd never met Steve.
So, still to this day.
No, we've met now. During the entire recording and the production of the album.
Wow, so you were kind of doing isolation before it was in.
Indeed. That's right. I was his Russian mail order bride who lived in Melbourne, who wasn't really from Russia, but who
still
had the
metaphorically.
Same. Yeah, right. Yeah, and he was my sonic crush, and I'd receive these lyrics, which I'm a bit of a I mean, I love great written words, poetry, and music and lyrics. In fact, I feel I'm rambling now, but a good friend of mine sent me Dylan's speech. For the did you hear what Dylan wrote?
Oh, the Nobel Prize for Literature. Yeah, it's amazing.
It is, and what he's saying essentially, which is something which couldn't be more truer in this period right now, is that if you're able to be quiet enough to hear the words within the song or the poem, you realise that there's several universes that are captured in one phrase, and with Steve, you know, he's the fucking whole Aurora Borealis.
He is. All at the same time.
All in his third eye. There's one whole galaxy right there.
Part of what Delivered Live does, the ticket money not only goes to all the artists and the soundies and the everyone behind the scenes, the managers, the ticketing agencies and so on that have struck it with a really tough time, the band, of course, but also venue. Every artist nominates a venue and a road crew member. Yeah. I'm wondering who you've nominated. They get a portion of the tickets that you buy tonight too.
Well, so my Friday live stream is also supporting Support Act, which also in some small way kind of helps all these as well.
Absolutely.
But I, it's so hard to think of one. I know that the memo has been really kind and I would love very much, but I also... the Caravan Club, because just before, you know, we spent so much of our Saturdays, all this band putting out a fire, which is why most of us can't afford to pay our mortgage now. And the Caravan Club opened their doors and allowed us to do a fundraiser there and they hosted it beautifully. So I'd like to give it to the crew there if I could.
Such an amazing sort of pocket of music lovers in and around Oakley in the eastern burbs there. They've got such a great... audience out there. Big hi to the Caravan. I love them too.
Yeah. Well, you know, I think live music and dare I say it, the North Side's been raging and Melbourne itself is one of the most famed live capitals of the world. Yeah. So I'm really waiting for the lights to turn back on and all the bars start to hum and those fridges get going and people and the talk and the chatter and everything. But, you know, I think that those small clubs in the meantime have been... the character of Melbourne, the way they pace their walls lovingly with every Melbourne artist that's ever travelled through there and others, of course, international artists and also from interstate. But I think we are very Melbourne-centric and we like that.
It's not bad. We've got it pretty good here considering...
Adelaide can have the arts festivals and the cabaret festivals. Let's have our Melbourne musicians who have such a, you know, a very inexplicable sort of Melbourne-ness.
And we delivered a big slice of the Melbourne
we
music.
We did deliver the slice of Melbourne-ness.
Form here. This is as close you can get to a gig here. A round of applause for the one, the only, Kate Ceberano.